I'm super excited to show you how to fix your computer's memory problem or RAM. So we got this problem, which says memory failure detected in slot 4. DIMM is the slot. And it gives us three options. One, F1 to continue and ignore the error. Then you can also press F2 to run the setup utility, or press F5 to run onboard diagnostics. So we first try by pressing F5 on your keyboard. The test is started. And then finally you might get this message saying you couldn't detect any problems. But if you want to do a more deep analysis, then press yes to continue. So let's press Y to continue for another half an hour. If this test is taking too long and you don't want to continue, you can just press escape and it can reboot your system by pressing enter. So if you press F1, your computer will continue as normal, and then you can go and manually shut down your computer by going here. Make sure your computer is fully shut down. And if you have got Dell PC, you can see the light is on number 2, and it means there is something wrong with the memory. Remove all the cables from the back. This computer is very easy to open. Just push this and this comes out. Touch the back of the computer so that the electrostatic comes out from your hands. And now we are safe to open the computer. Take this out. You can see all the memories are there. I don't know how clear it is, but it shows DIMM1 is this one, and then DIMM4 is this one. It's not in sequence for some reason. So from the message, we know that DIMM4 is not working very well. So we need to try to take this out and then reinsert it and make sure that it's secure enough. And on your own computer, make sure you take out the right one according to your computer. So let's try to take this out by pressing the ends and then just take it out. One of the things that you need is this, a brush. This can help you to clean any dust from the memory. Recently, I was renovating my home and I sanded the walls. It caused a lot of dust. And obviously the dust went to the computer. Dust is one of the main reasons for memory failure. Memory doesn't fail very often, and it doesn't usually break because it's not a moving part. So you might have to take your memory out, clean it very well, put it back in and try again. You might have to try this process a few times. And after a few times, if it doesn't work, then it shows that your memory actually has failed, physically failed. That means you would have to replace your memory or live without that additional memory. Gently brush the memory using this brush and make sure the place where it's connected to the motherboard is clear from any dust, and that we would have a strong connection between the memory and the motherboard. Do it either side. And now we're gonna reinsert it to the slot. Make sure you hear the tick sound and that it is tight. Now we put the cap on again. Close this, put the case, and we are ready to start the computer. And then you will not get the error message anymore, but you will get a message like this saying that the amount of the system memory has changed. Press F1 to continue. So yes, press F1 to continue. So now if you go and restart your computer, you should not get the error message anymore. So let's restart. And you saw there, we didn't get any message anymore. That means the configuration has restated itself. I hope this video was useful. If it was, please don't forget to subscribe, and I hope to see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.